iPhone is really easy to use. It is all the more surprising that it has so many unknown but useful features. As you know, you can zoom in and out almost everywhere using two fingers. Of course, you can do that in Photos, Safari, and so on. But there are apps where it doesn't work. For example, it doesn't work in Instagram Stories, or it doesn't work in my weather app Weather Pro. And of course, it doesn't work on the home screen either, but sometimes it can still be useful to zoom in even in these cases. That's what the zoom feature is for. You tap with three fingers twice quickly on the area you want to zoom in. Now you can always change the section with three fingers and move back and forth. You have to activate this feature for it to work. You do this under Settings, Accessibility and Zoom. Here you will also find a number of other settings for the zoom feature. For example, you can change the zoom level here. If you rarely need the zoom feature and want to activate and deactivate it quickly and easily, I recommend the following feature. You quickly press the side button 3 times. Now it is activated, and again 3 times, then it is deactivated again. As you can imagine, you also have to activate this triple click to make it work. And you can do that in the accessibility menu under Accessibility Shortcut. Here at the bottom you'll find Zoom. As you can see, you can also enable other features for the triple click, like the magnifier app or voice control. We will come back to this feature later. Let's stay in the accessibility menu for a moment. In my last iPhone tricks video, I showed you how to take a photo without touching your iPhone using shortcuts and Siri, for example to take a group selfie. Today I'll show you how to achieve the same goal using voice control. To do this, select voice control here in the accessibility menu. You activate it and then select customize commands. Here you can already see that there are a number of preset voice commands, but we choose custom and create a new command. Now here we enter our voice command. To take a photo, I'll use just as an example, say money. That will make our group smile for the photo. Then I select action and run custom gesture. Now you have to do exactly the action, the tap, that you want the iPhone to do on your voice command. Now here's where there is a difficulty. You have to tap once exactly where the shutter button of the camera is. So right here. To find the right point, you should mark it somehow. Then you select stop and save. Now when we switch to the camera app and say our voice command, our save tap will be executed and we can easily take our group selfie. Say money. Now let's say you don't want to take your group photo with a voice command, but you ask a stranger on the street if he or she could take the photo. But you don't want him or her to leave the Photos app or have access to your photos or do anything else with your iPhone. For this you use Guided Access. You can also find this feature under Accessibility. At the very bottom, under General, you activate Guided Access here. As you can read here, Guided Access is also activated with a triple click. To avoid confusion, I have already deactivated the triple click for the zoom feature. Now switch to the app you want to use, in our example the camera app, and activate Guided Access with a triple click. Here you can mark all areas of the touchscreen that should be disabled, for example the preview at the bottom left, or everything except the shutter button. The feature is now assigned a code. So what does it all mean now? Whenever you switch to the camera app, you can activate Guided Access with a triple click and your code or Face ID. You can hand over your iPhone without worry. The app can't be left without the code and except for the shutter button, your iPhone is unusable. This feature is also suitable if you give your iPhone to your child to play a game or to any other person to use an app. With Guided Access, you can restrict the use of your iPhone to one app and even an area of the touchscreen. And while we're on the subject of children, let's assume you're in an important meeting and don't want to be disturbed. Then you might switch your iPhone to silent using the silent switch here on the left. Or you activate Do Not Disturb. But you want your children to be able to reach you at any time. After all, it could be an emergency. To set this, select the person in your contacts who should always be able to reach you. Now tap on Edit and Ringtone and activate Emergency Bypass. Your iPhone will now ring and vibrate when this person calls, even if it is set to silent. And because we are already at the vibration alert, you can create your own vibration alert for specific people. This way, you can recognize who is calling without sound and only by the vibration. To do this, select Edit under Contacts, then Ringtone, and now Vibration. Down here under Custom, you can now create a new vibration alert. With Save, you have to save it and give it a name. Now I have two cool tricks related to screenshots. If you take a screenshot and tap on it, then you can edit the screenshot. If you tap on the plus at the bottom right here, you'll find additional options. I find signature especially interesting to add your digital signature to a document. or magnifier to highlight certain areas of the screenshot. If you tap and hold the blue dot, you can drag the circle bigger and smaller. If you move the green dot up and down, you can zoom in and out. And the next trick is also very useful. If you want to share your screenshot immediately without editing it, you just tap and hold the preview. Now the usual sharing options appear and you can share the screenshot via AirDrop, mail or messages without delay. I also have some very useful tricks for you for Safari. As you probably know, in Safari, you can just type your search terms in the address bar and you don't have to use a dedicated search engine to search the web. For example, let's type iPhone. Now Safari will suggest a few search combinations. For example, iPhone 13 or iPhone 13 Pro Max. If you like one of them, you can let Safari make more detailed suggestions by tapping on the arrow here on the right. As you can see, Safari now suggests iPhone 13 Pro Max price or prezzo or 256 GB. So the arrow has the function to refine the search suggestion. By the way, via the address bar, you can search not only the web, but also for keywords on a website. This is for example the website 9to5Mac. Here I want to search for the keyword Apple. And as you can see here below, there is the word Apple 35 times on this page. You tap on it and then you can use the arrows here on the right to look through each of the results. As some of you know, I live in Italy. But interestingly enough, people in my region also speak German. You can easily hear that from my accent. And you can imagine that this situation is not always easy in terms of language. And translations of texts are really important. And not only Google Chrome has an instant translation feature. Safari on the iPhone can also translate a web page automatically. For example, I want to display this web page in Italian. So I tap on the AA and here I tap on Italiano and the whole web page is displayed in Italian. For me, an incredibly useful feature. By the way, you can easily send a website to a contact using Siri. Just say, "Hey Siri, send this website to Werner." And Siri will send the website to the contact you selected. This also works with screenshots. "Hey Siri, send this screenshot to Werner."
"Ready to send it?"
If you want to know if you have a legit iPhone and not a fake one, after all there seem to be a lot of fakes around, or if you want to know which services your iPhone is still covered by, you can check your serial number at Apple. To do this, open the settings and here, right at the top, About. Now tap on serial number and copy the serial number. If you now enter check serial number in Safari, you will immediately find the correct website. Here you paste the serial number, enter the code, and you will get all the information you need about your iPhone. Let's talk about time. When you open the calendar app, you enter a new appointment. You can set the time with this kind of dial. If that bugs you or if that's too inaccurate for you, you can tap on the time and now you can enter the time manually. It is similar when you set an alarm clock. Again, you can enter the time manually with an additional tap. The Messages app is not as popular here in Italy as it is in the US. We use WhatsApp more often. Unfortunately, I have to say, because the Messages app has some very interesting and useful features. For example, if you type "I'm at" in the text field, you immediately have the option to share your current location here. Also cool is Digital Touch. With it, you can send drawings, but also kisses, the heartbeat, or even broken hearts. To do so, tap on the heart icon. The digital input field now appears here in black. Tap with two fingers for a kiss. Tap and hold with two fingers for the heartbeat. If you drag both fingers downwards during the heartbeat, you will create a broken heart. And another cool trick for iMessage. If you swipe to the left, you will also see the icons for TikTok or YouTube here. This feature allows you to share videos you've recently watched without any additional hassle. The history of your most recently viewed videos is displayed. If you want to share another video, you can also use the search feature. All without detours and without having to open the YouTube app. But WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger also have a very interesting and useful feature. Earlier we had the situation that in certain cases you might hand your iPhone to another person and maybe you don't want anyone to ever have access to your messages. It is possible to protect the access to WhatsApp with Face ID. To do this, go to Settings, here Account, then Privacy, and here you scroll all the way down. Here there is a feature called Screen Lock. If you activate this feature, you need Face ID to unlock WhatsApp. This means that WhatsApp can only be opened using Face ID or your code. A very useful feature in my opinion. And since we're already talking about privacy, I'm sure that you too are constantly receiving emails from companies because you may have created an account somewhere. Let's call these mails newsletters. Of course, you can unsubscribe from these newsletters, but this is sometimes inconvenient and may not always work. Some companies want to make it difficult for you. That's why you can block certain senders in the mail app. And this is very easy. You open the respective mail and tap once on the name of the sender. Now you have several options. One of them is block this contact. And now you are rid of the annoying mails from the sender forever. Let's stay in the mail app for a moment. As you know, your mails on the iPhone contain the default signature "sent from my iPhone." In the long run, this doesn't make sense. Most of the time, you will even delete the signature in a cumbersome way. So it would be better to change it right away and replace it with your own name, for example. To do this, open the Settings app and select the Mail app. Scroll down to the bottom and find the signature. Now you can replace the signature "sent from my iPhone" with your name. You can also decide if this signature should be like this for all your mail accounts or only for certain ones. Did you see that I have a little globe icon up here? You can also add other icons here. This is the icon for a focus mode. As you might know, you can use focus mode to customize your iPhone to certain situations. Then you'll only get messages from certain contacts or apps. You can create your own focus mode under Settings and Focus. Now tap on the plus and then on Custom. Now you have to give your custom focus mode a name, for example Test. And here you can choose an icon from this list, which will appear in the upper left corner next to the time when the focus mode is active. I choose the globe here below. Here you can configure the settings for this focus mode, which messages and calls you should receive while the focus mode is active. If you want to learn even more tricks about the iPhone 13 or 13 Pro and Pro Max, I recommend my video about the 20 most useful hidden features. You can also find a link to it in the video description. And give me a like as feedback if this video was interesting for you. There will be more tips and tutorials for the iPhone. So stay tuned and see you next time.